Hey folks, this is Vince with Ad Gaming Addiction, and once again we're going to commentate on a game of X-Wing that Vid and I recently played. As you can see, I played as the Imperial Fleet. We both have 100 points. This is my first time playing as the TIE Striker, so I was interested to try that out. So we've got Rear Admiral Sherinu, I'm going to mispronounce these names, VT-49 Decimator with Adaptability, so in effect he's got a 9. Instead of an 8, And then we've got Backdraft and the TIE Fighter Special Forces. Special Ops Training with Lone Wolf. And last but not least, we've got Pure Sabak and the TIE Striker. And I'm going to mispronounce this title as well. Adaptive Ailerons with Push the Limit. And again, all of that came to 100 points. Now, Vinny was playing as the Scum faction, and I think he was trying out the Protectorate Starfighter. That was a new ship for him. Now, I'm going to be reading these upside down, so I'm going to do my best here. Fen Rao in the Protectorate Starfighter. All right, that's a better shot. He's got Expose, Concord Dawn, Protectorate Title, and Stealth Device, making him very hard to hit. Then we've got Cesaru and the M3A Interceptor with Predator, Mangler Cannon, Heavy Skike Interceptor Title, and the Shield Upgrade. Last but not least, Cavil and the Y-Wing with the Blaster Turret, the R4 Agro Mech, and Veteran Instinct. So he's got some high pilot skills to go along with that. So let's get the game started. It's always a challenge to try and get this camera to be straight, but it's like propped up on a footstool. I need to find some sort of stand that I can use for my video camera that it's actually high, so I can so it overlooks the board. But I have it standing up on a footstool right now, so it's a little crooked. Oh well. I like this angle though better than my previous angles. Now, I think I rolled for initiative, or someone did. I ended up getting initiative. So I get to move first and shoot first when equal pilot skills are concerned. My 6 goes first. And I just remembered here I had those adaptive ailerons, if that's how you pronounce it. So I have to go one straight or one slight turn and then make my maneuver. And I'm going to take a barrel action here, just in case that asteroid would cause an issue in the future turn. Now, knowing that his two ships were, like, going to joust me here, I went ahead and moved my TIE fighter toward the direction of my decimator in the hopes of getting to safety. But Backdraft also has that special ability where if he fires at his auxiliary firing arc, he gets to add a critical result to his hit roll, which is pretty good. So I was trying to make him into my rear firing arc anyway, if I could. Alright, so he's moving up with his ships. And again, for the first round, we generally don't take any actions unless it's a barrel roll. Just because we generally don't, we're never in range to actually do anything. And we give up unused tokens during the end phase anyway, so... unless it's something that we can keep or take action on right now, like a barrel roll or boost, we don't bother doing it. And he's just... again, we fly casually. He was just... they both moved 4 straight, so he just moved his one fighter up next to his other one. If that were tournament play, that would not fly. But in my house, I don't care. Okay, so next round. I'm trying to hug these asteroids here with my decimator because, well, it's not going to fit very well in there. So I'm trying to plane around it. Luckily, the decimator has a 360 firing arc. So that doesn't bother me. All right. And again, I have to do some type of one maneuver here and then move after that. 3 straight yet again. Trying to come at him from the side. I do not want to joust with that Protectorate at all. That Protectorate is a nasty jouster. especially at range 1, so I don't want to get anywhere near it at range 1, trying to come at it from the side if I can. Not going to chance those asteroids if I can help it either. Trying to play it safe. My TIE Striker doesn't have any shields either. And TIE Strike, that Pierce a Box ability, one or fewer damage cards, and I get to roll one additional attack die. So it behooves me to keep this guy, that TIE Striker, untouched if at all possible. But Cavil also has that turret that can fire 360s. It's a blaster turret. So, you know, there's that. Alright, so what is he doing? Okay, I don't think he's in range to do anything. Like, we're measuring here. Nope. Oh, yeah, that's right. I think we screwed up the order, the movement order on this. We were trying to get used to the adaptability. Oh, there goes the model. Wasn't on there, right? He had veteran instincts on, I think, one of his as well. So he had like an 8. 8, 9, and 9. And my decimator was a 9 as well, but I had the initiative, so I got to move first and shoot first. Okay, so this round something's bound to happen, maybe. If we keep avoiding each other, we'll see. And again, I have to do some sort of one maneuver here. Then I make a 1. There we go. So I really like those adaptive ailerons. I'm going to be mispronouncing this for the entire video, by the way. I did push the limit there, got my evade token. Again, I'm trying to keep this guy untouched, if at all possible. That's why I took push the limit with him. That evade token, you know, was, you know, going to help me do that, if at all possible. That extra evade token might be the deciding factor between 2 damage cards and 1, should I take a hit. So, again, 1 or fewer damage cards, they get an extra attack die with Pure Sabak in the TIE Striker. Now, the TIE Fighter here, sort of just out of the picture. I was hoping one of his ships would follow me and he would split up his forces, but he didn't take the bait, I don't believe. Now, my other two ships here, the Decimator and the TIE Striker, nice range here. Alright, Cavil was also a 9 at this point because of his veteran instincts. He took a focus. So my 9 gets to shoot first. Well, actually, no, he has to move first. Here we go. His protectorate moves up. Okay. Yeah, first my 9, then his 9s. We seem to be favoring high pilot skills lately. Being able to shoot first and wipe him out before he can shoot back is nice. Alright, so I think I got... Alright, now, Rear Admiral Charnu's ability allows me to change a focus to a crit automatically. So, he took 3 damage there, and all 3 of his shields are gone. So the Y-Wing has 5 hull left at this point. Now, the Y-Wing is a 9, is going to attack somebody, probably the TIE Striker there. With the blaster turret, give up the focus to do it. And he gets a target lock with the agromech. When you spend a focus, you get a target lock, and that's what the blaster turret allows him to do. So he got a free target lock on that, which he's going to spend, I think. And he gets 4 attack dice because Cavil is out. Or it's my ship is outside his primary firing arc. Cavil has that ability. You get an extra attack die if outside the firing arc. I take 1 damage here, by the way. So. That's 1 hit. I still have my 4 attack die special. So, now his 9 is not in range. So, I get to shoot back with TIE Striker, because my 7, my special forces TIE, not in range of anything. 4 hits and a blank. So, he's got 4 face-down damage cards on his Y-Wing. 1 more hit and it's gone. So, his Y-Wing is getting pounded here. But, hey, it's still in the game, so that's what counts. And here we go debating. This is a tough one. I was really hoping that, I was thinking that protectorate was going to follow my TIE fighter and split his forces up, and I was going to try and blow up his other ships with my TIE Striker with 4 attack dice and my Decimator with 3 attack dice, while my TIE fighter just sort of used his rear firing arc to take off a few pot shots at someone that might be following him. Just try and split up his forces a bit. But knowing Vinny, it never works out that way. He's come to be very good at this game. Very good at it. Now he took expose on the protectorate because at range 1 he gets all sorts of Nasty's abilities. So if he takes expose at range 1, he gets an additional attack die. So in effect, he could probably attack with like 6 attack dice depending on the situation with all of his upgrade cards and abilities and everything like that. All right. So I barely get to move up without hitting him, and I did push the limit. Focus target lock or focus and evade rather. TIE fighter's just biding his time over there, waiting for someone to follow him and chase him. All right, now his smaller ship there. I mean, it's not very strong with 2 hull and 1 shield. He does have a shield upgrade on it, so it's actually 2 shields, but he's got that cannon on it, so I got to be careful. All right, target lock on the Y-wing. And now the Y-wing is going to try and get out of there. Now, his template overlapped the obstacle, so he's got to roll for damage. He did take a hit, so Y-wing is out. So my target lock went to waste, but the Y-wing is off the board. And his protectorate is moving in, ignoring my TIE fighter. Not what all what I was trying to do at all. So what's going on here? It looks like I'm deciding on who to attack here. I could either shoot at the smaller ship through the asteroid or at the protectorate who has a stealth device. So either way, he's going to be rolling 4 or 5 defense dice. So I'm trying to take out the weaker ship out of the two, especially because he's got a cannon on top of it. So that's 1 crit. He's got like, I don't know, 2 evade there or 1 evade. I don't know. So it missed. No problem. All right, now he's attacking the TIE Striker. I've only got 2 defense die. All right, so I have to spend a focus. No damage from the looks of it. And now his other ship is going to attack the TIE Striker. He's trying to get another damage on the TIE Striker so that I lose that extra attack die special that I have on that pilot. And I think this is his Mangler cannon. Yeah, he's changing a hit to a crit. 2 evades, I take 1 crit. So I lose the ability. And this is what killed me. Loose stabilizer. Every time I execute a white maneuver, I get a stress token. And I have to take a white maneuver with my adaptive ailerons. So throughout the entire game, I've already got one with push the limit. So there's no way I can clear it. Every time at the beginning of my maneuver, I have to take a white maneuver. That is my adaptive aileron. So I'm never going to clear stress with this guy for the rest of the game. So, no more actions for him, basically, is what it boils down to, which kind of stinks. All right. And it looks like I might have gotten a hit, possibly on the interceptor there. I don't see any more shields on it. It's the card closest to Vinny, the pilot. No. No, it's the second card in. Okay, he lost a shield. From the looks of it. Normally you get 1 shield with that ship, but He had the shield upgrade, so he had two. So he only has one there showing, so I'm assuming I'd hit once. Okay. Now again, I've got that adaptive aileron crap going. So yeah, I decided to do a one slight turn and basically get the heck out of there. I took a stress token with the white maneuver, had to take it. And this was a green maneuver, so I lose one, but I still can't take an action. I think it was three straight? Yeah. The TIE Striker doesn't get to go very far. It's only like a... it can only go up to speed three. So it's not like I had a lot of room for maneuvering. But again, those adaptive ailerons sort of make up for that. So slowly I'm trying to get my TIE Fighter back into the fray, knowing that no one's going to chase me at this point. So now he's going after the Decimator, trying to clear that out. I don't know if that was a mistake or not, but he's certainly at the range to do it. He's got a nice range one bonus on me. The Interceptor there has a Mangler Cannon. His Protectorate Starfighter has a lot of bonuses at range one. And it looks like he's taking a boost action so that he can get to range one. Yep. So, yeah, he's going to be rolling a lot of attack dice. My Decimator has zero agility, so it could literally get blown the crap up here if Vinny rolls really well. So I'm spending target locks here, and I've got two hits and two crits. He's using his focus, I think, and takes a crit. I think, yeah. He got Shaken Pilot. But he's still not out of the game. His shield upgrade saved him. If he had not taken that shield upgrade, he would have been dead right here. So that actually saved him. And now he's at a nice range one shot opportunity. My other two ships are too far away to do much of anything at the moment. Yeah, he's rolling five attack dice with his Protectorate. Two damage, though. I got lucky. I lost two shields. And now he's going to shoot with his Mangler, I think it is. So two hits, and I get a damage card. Oh, the Mangler lets him put a hit to a crit, so I had to take a crit. And I receive one stress token, then flip this card face down. Okay. So that wasn't too bad. It could have been a lot worse for the Decimator there. The Decimator still has 12 hull by default, so I still need 11 more hits before I'm out. So it can take some punishment. So I'm hoping to take out, even if my Decimator gets taken out here, I'm hoping to take out one ship and possibly do damage to another one, and then let my other two sort of clean up the mess after that. My TIE Fighter right now is untouched. My other one's in bad shape with a stress, a permanent stress that's never going to go away. And when I start taking white maneuvers with that thing, that's my white maneuver that I've got to take. And I think I took a one hard turn here. That's a white maneuver, so that's another stress token. And again, I can't take red maneuvers when I've got a stress token, but I can still take white maneuvers and green maneuvers. But every time I take a white, I get a stress. So now I've got three stress tokens. Never going to happen. I'm never going to get rid of this stress token. It's going to be impossible. Now, had I had the Duchess, I wouldn't have had this issue. But I liked Pure Sabacc's ability. All right, so the Interceptor's moving up there. And he flipped his one critical face down because he didn't do a straight maneuver that turn. And he's doing a bearer roll. That was a questionable bearer roll, Vinny. That definitely did not touch the entire flat side of the template, but whatever. I'm not going to argue with him. Again, we play for fun. Now, he did a 4K turn here. He's still in range one of the Decimator. Probably not what I would have done in this situation. I probably would have tried to keep him on a white or green maneuver just so that I could take an action. All right, and the Interceptor takes at least one hit and is knocked out. And now the Protectorate shoots back with five attack dice, no agility for the Decimator. So I take, what, four damage there? Three, okay. My other two ships are not in range to do anything right now. But that's okay. My Decimator, my goal was just to sort of knock him out. Now, the Protectorate here is going to be hard to hit. I mean, he's got that stealth device on top of his 3 agility. So he's got 4 defense dice right now. Plus, if there's a range bonus of 3 or an asteroid, anything like that, he's going to have 5 or 6 defense dice. And he's going to be very hard to hit. So this will be interesting. All right, so there's my required move, and then here's my other white maneuver. So I didn't bother adding more stress token. Well, I did, okay. Yeah, at this point I'm like, screw it. I'm not gonna add any more stress tokens. We know that he's never ever gonna not be stressed, so I'm just like, I threw my hands up. Now, even though backdraft favors the rear firing arc, I still have the Special Forces TIE title on this, or the it's a special title on the Special Forces TIE. Lets me shoot 3 attack dice out of the front. All right, so I'm at range 3 there. Got a target lock. It's at range 3 though, so he gets 5 defense dice. One for range 3, one for a stealth device. And then 3 more for his regular agility. So no damage rolled there. He keeps his stealth device. He's trying to roll up my TIE fighter here. He gets possibly 3 attack dice. Yeah, one hit, 2 blanks. One evade, no damage. I got lucky there. So I get 3 attack dice there. Plus Lone Wolf lets me. I'm at least, I have to be at least within one. I have to be further than 1 or 2, and I can reroll a blank result. So it was 2 hits, no damage, is what it came out to be. So no damage was done there at all. His stealth device was working well. I couldn't do anything. Now this sets me up for my TIE fighter to shoot out of my rear firing arc. I suspected him to turn into the asteroid field, and then my TIE fighter would go straight into my rear firing arc, but we'll see what happens. And my other guy here, he's just. I did not want him to get hit. I knew he was going to fly into the asteroid field, so my goal was to try and just make him chase me and get behind asteroids if I could. I still had 3 attack dice, yes, but he had the higher pilot skill. He could shoot and kill me before anything happened. So I was trying to get him to chase my TIE Striker while my TIE fighter shot out of my rear firing arc. Because I thought he was going to turn into the asteroid field. He might have, I don't know, I don't remember. Not in range, so. He went straight instead, which I did not expect. And he's going to boost, giving him a shot on my TIE Striker. That's through an asteroid, so I do get 3, possibly 3 attack dice here. Or no, it's not through the asteroid. So he gets 3 attack die, I get 2 defense dice. Let's see what he rolls. No, I got two hits to evade, no damage. I was very lucky. Rear firing arc, I get to add at least one critical to my roll. So basically, yeah, I roll 2 attack dice, and then I get a crit on top of it for free with Backdraft's ability. Now he gets, on the other hand, even though that all that happens, he's at range 3 with an asteroid. So it's again his protectorate here is doing very well. And there's my poor TIE Striker, stressed beyond belief. He needs Ambien really bad. Unfortunately, space is a cruel beast and has no such thing. It's not like you can open your cockpit, suck in some Zoloft and continue flying. No, you can't do that. Now my TIE Striker here was in trouble. I didn't know what he was gonna do, so I just went for broke. I could have turned toward the camera with my TIE Striker here. I was thinking about doing that to try and get out of his arc. But if he went, if I would, I had two choices. I could either go toward the camera or toward him. I was hoping he would turn toward me, thinking I would be running away, and then we'd be outside of each other's firing arc. That's what I was hoping. All right, so yeah, there goes the template. There we go. Moving in. Focus. And lo and behold, it worked. See, we're outside each other's firing arc. That's what I was hoping for. However, Vinny, being as smart as he is, pulled a barrel roll on me. And now he's at range one, inside the firing arc. Whole bunch of bonuses that the Protectorate has starts kicking in here. And he starts getting a mad. He's got like, what, five, six attack dice? I'm not sure how many it is. He gets a lot of bonuses jousting with the Protectorate like this. Again, I read his cards off in the beginning of the video there, but I did do a video of the Protectorate, so if you want to see these in closer detail, go check that out. But yeah, he's got like, what, three hits here. I got like one evade. Yeah, I'm dead. No more stress, though. That's one way to clear stress. All right, so one Imperial ship down. And he still is untouched. Stealth device and everything. He's still kicking it. He's gonna be hard to hit. All right, TIE fighters moving up nice and slow here. I'm waiting to see what he does before I swing in with my TIE fighter. I'd rather him take shots at my decimator as opposed to my TIE fighter. Just because my decimator can take it. He can take a few more hits. Range three. Target lock. Now I have a focus. And what did he do? Did he? No damage? Oh, yeah. He rolled a def I don't know why he rolled more defense dice, but yeah, no damage for him. He's rolling. He had one hit. He had one crit, and unfortunately, I couldn't roll a focus to save my life. I got a damage sensor array. Could not perform actions until I rolled a hit or crit as an action. So now I'm in trouble. My decimator cannot take actions until I get rid of that damage card. Which is going to stink when we get into close range, because I'd want to take a target lock or something to up my chances of actually hitting him, especially with his stealth device. So it's like my decimator now is in quite a bit of trouble. So I had a choice to make. Do I go away from the camera and run and try and clear that damage? Or do I try and psych him out and fly right at him and hope for the best? And maybe get him to run into me on top of it. I don't know. I didn't know what he was going to pick. All right, so my TIE fighter goes first. I'm doing a two hard turn here. Trying to get him on the side if I can help it. Took a focus, did a three hard turn there, hoping he'd run into me. As my action, rolled the die, got a hit, and flipped it face down. So now I can take actions for following turns, assuming I don't die right here and now. Now he did a three slight turn, thinking I wouldn't go that far. So he ran into me. Took no action. I got at range three, get to roll some dice. Now I've got Lone Wolf and I've got three attack dice. All right, so I spent my focus, two hits. I got lucky here. No, did he? He's okay. Yeah, he's all right. No damage. No damage. Again, stealth device, range three. All of these things, all of these defense dice. It's his Protectorate, man. It's just impossible to hit. He has no shields, but he's swerving in and out of these shots like a pro. He's not taking any hits. I might have to try, like, I might have to buy more than one protectorate and then fly a swarm of them to see how well I do. They look a lot of fun. All right, so there's my TIE fighter. Like, I know his protectorate doesn't have a whole lot of ways to move. That with that asteroid being there to the decimator's right, he's got to move. He can't do a hard turn. He's got to go straight or a bend or something. So I'm hoping my TIE fighter here can do something. All right, so there's my decimator at range 3. He took a focus. So 3 attack dice, target lock. And 1 damage. It was enough to get rid of his stealth device, and he takes a crit, which is damaged engine. All hard turns are red maneuvers. Okay, so my goal of getting his stealth device off of him is complete. Lucky for me, I get 3 attack dice here. Lone wolf did not work here because I was at range 2. So no lone wolf, but I still rolled, got 2 hit and a crit. Use my focus. And he rolled 2 blanks and a focus. That's three damage, I think. And he's gone. That was an excellent game that Vinny played, I gotta say. I'm really liking that TIE Striker. I know you guys didn't get to see a whole lot of it in the last game because I blew it up so quickly. But that protectorate. Now I've got to try the protectorate and see what all I can do with it. So stay tuned. If you guys haven't already, subscribe to my channel and check out my official website, www.dadsgamingaddiction.com. This is Vince. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next time.